Hello, welcome to the second video in a series of Linux for Beginners. The first video was deciding if Linux is a good fit for you, and now this video will walk you through how to pick a distro, as well as installing Linux. This guide won't be covering dual booting, unfortunately, because it can get pretty messy, and I don't want to bloat this video too much. There are plenty of ways to learn how to do it, but you may run into some issues, and if you aren't super computer savvy, it will definitely cause issues, so you have been warned. Without further ado, let's begin. First, let's start with picking a Linux distro, which is the flavor, so to speak, of Linux. You can do your own research into the seemingly endless amount of distros out there, but my recommendation today is CacheOS with KDE Plasma. I'm going to explain why, but if you're not interested, feel free to skip to the installation timestamp, where I go over how to actually install Linux. There's a big split between kinds of Linux distros, Debian-based and Arch-based. Debian updates slower but is more reliable, and Arch updates constantly but is unstable. The thing is, the new updates typically add stability to Linux, at least for gaming. If your main use case for a computer is to use a browser and watch movies or something, then I completely agree that a Debian flavor like Linux Mint or PopOS is a solid choice. But if you're a gamer, Arch is a pretty compelling option. Since most Arch systems have access to updates so much faster, they get fixes for games much faster as well. I convinced one of my friends to try Linux, and they opted for Linux Mint, but I found out that their GPU drivers, which are stable and up to date, were from around May of this year, and were missing some fixes for games. There's probably some kind of way to download the newest drivers on Debian, but it's frankly a hassle and you might as well just use Arch. It's not impossible to game on Linux Mint, in fact it's pretty popular, but I feel like right now I'd prefer to be on Arch in most cases. Next, after picking between those two, you need to pick a desktop environment or a window manager. It's what you actually interact with as an end user. If you use distros with the same desktop environment, you'll have a pretty similar experience overall, with the differences usually being that the distro pre-selects some options for you and installs some other stuff which may or may not be helpful. There's a lot of them available, but if you're coming from Windows and want something pretty similar to it, I recommend KDE Plasma. You'll be instantly familiar since Windows, the taskbar, and start menu all function more or less like how it does on Windows. It's also very popular, meaning that if you need help learning more about it, then you can probably find some answers online to help you. Next, we have window managers. These work nothing like desktop environments. You don't have a desktop, you don't even need a taskbar if you don't want it, and it usually doesn't function like a taskbar anyway. Sometimes there's no X's in the top right to close or minimize, so what the heck is going on? The main benefit of tiling window managers is how everything is automatically sorted and resized for you, as well as being super minimalist. Overall, this is my favorite way to use Linux, but requires you to learn some keybinds, which in my opinion is really easy. Not to mention, you can customize them if you don't like how they feel. Of all the window managers there are, I recommend Hyperlan. It looks the best out of the box and is really popular, so a lot of people can help you with it. There are other interesting ones too that have some slightly different functionality, so I recommend you dive deep into this if you're interested. There's no real wrong answer to which desktop environment you pick, but I would strongly suggest against any one of them that is based on X11. If you go to your terminal and type this command, you can find out if you're on X11 or Wayland. X11 is the older and therefore more stable windowing system, but Wayland is newer and even some stable distros are switching to it. It can fall back to X11 using X-Wayland anyway, so there's not a huge downside to using Wayland. If you do use an X11 desktop environment, expect that one day you'll have to update to Wayland, and that may or may not be a hassle. It's better to just be on Wayland from the start in my opinion, and for an end user, you likely won't notice the difference between the two anyway. In the end, if you decide to swap between desktop environments or between window managers, it's easy to install them alongside each other. On your login screen, you can usually pick which one you want to use, so feel free to try them out. You can even install both an X11-based environment and a Wayland-based environment alongside each other if you really want to. Okay, so now we understand what goes into Linux distros. From my recommendation so far, it would be an Arch-based distro with KDE Plasma or Hyperlan running on Wayland. With all these combined, my pick is CacheOS, though there are other distros that fit the bill, like EndeavorOS. The main thing that sets CacheOS apart is that CacheOS basically does some wizardry on the backend that try to improve the performance of applications, and that's what I prefer. CacheOS luckily offers a lot of desktop environments and has a wiki that gives some descriptions of all the options when you're installing, including File System and Boot Manager. I'll link it in the description. Great, after all that buildup, we finally picked a distro and have a game plan. How do we actually install it? First, make sure you have a USB stick that's around 4GB or larger. Then, hop on a browser and go to download Rufus Portable. Next, go to your distro of choice's website and download their .iso file. From there, open Rufus and under Device, make sure your USB stick is selected. Then click on the Select button and pick the .iso that you downloaded. You're pretty much good to go. Just press Start and wait for it to be done. After it finishes up, open your power menu in Windows and hold Shift while clicking Restart. After a few seconds, it should pop up a menu. Click Troubleshoot, then Advanced Options, then UEFI Firmware Settings. It should then prompt you to restart. When it does, you'll be in a strange menu. I can't exactly help you from here because it differs from manufacturer to manufacturer, but you have two main goals. First, somewhere it should show boot devices. Make sure your USB stick is the top priority number one. Next, usually somewhere there's an option to switch to advanced mode. Go there and probably under the security tab, turn secure boot off. Make sure the changes are saved and then reboot. You should now be booting into your USB stick. You can tell you're booted into your USB stick because it'll look something like this. From there, just press enter to enter into the top entry, booting your Linux distro. Eventually you should reach a desktop. Different distros have a self-explanatory installer usually, and that includes CacheOS, and I'll quickly run through it. Click Launch Installer, and the first thing it asks is what bootloader you want to use. Grub is tried and true, but all have their pros and cons, which you can read about on the CacheOS wiki. I just picked Grub because I'm familiar with it. Next comes the pretty standard stuff like language, time zone, keyboard layout, and then we reach the Partitions tab. Here's where you'll want to make sure you're installing to the correct drive. At the top you can pick your storage device, and then you'll have a few other options. You want to pick Erase Disk, and under it pick BTRFS, which is pronounced as ButterFS. Next, we have the place where you can pick your desktop environment or window manager of choice. I'll be going with KDE Plasma at the top, but feel free to browse if you haven't completely made up your mind. In the next screen, you can choose what other stuff you want to install. You basically shouldn't touch anything until after Wayfire. You can add some support for printing and accessibility if you want, and uncheck Firefox if you prefer a different browser. Next, you can make your user as well as name of your computer. Put in a password and you're done. Do not check the box to log in automatically without the password, unless you want that for some reason. I'm doing it here because I'm doing this in a virtual machine. And that's it. It'll give you a little summary, just click install and install now, and then you're off to the races. It took about 5 minutes to install on this virtual machine, so don't be too hasty and think it got stuck. It then prompts you to restart when you're ready. I like to shut down manually by clicking in the bottom left and shutting down, then pulling out the USB when it's fully shut down. If everything went right, the next time you turn on your computer, you should be in Linux. If you boot into Windows though, repeat the steps to get to your UEFI firmware settings and change the boot order to prioritize Linux. And from there, you're done. You've successfully installed Linux. In a distro, there's usually a built-in place to install apps. CacheOS has this pop-up with an Install Apps button at the bottom where you can get started. Woo! We did it. My next video will go over what you can do with this Linux install and how to pretty much do everything you're used to without the terminal. It should be releasing in a few days from this video coming out. Feel free to check out the playlist and also drop a comment if you have any questions or need help. Alright, thanks for watching. See you over there.